Hello and welcome to a Thursday edition of Remy's Rave of the Day. I'm your host, Remy, or better known as Remington Afri, the youth minister at the Meadows Church of Christ right here in Beaumont in the great state of Texas. We are not raving about a word or a phrase today, but raving about a message in which was delivered a couple weeks ago at the camp in which the area churches here in Beaumont attends, Camp Red Oak. Our theme for this year was walking in the footsteps of Christ. And so we looked at his early childhood, his teaching, his work, his friendship, and we've also looked at his love. How did Jesus walk concerning that subject, his love? And so I want us to be able to explore that, share that message with you, and being able to show you, hey, this is how Jesus walked, and if we're gonna walk in his footsteps, then we gotta walk in that kind of a way as well. So if you have your Bibles, grab them and turn to John chapter 13. John chapter 13, this is how Jesus walked when it came to his love. John chapter 13, when you look at verse 34 and 35, Jesus says, "A new commandment I give to you, that you would love one another, even as I have loved you, that you also love one another. By this, all men will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another." We talked about this idea of selfless love. That's what friends do. Remember, that was John chapter 15, 12, and 13. And so Jesus is still repeating this idea, even though it's a chapter, or about two chapters before he says that idea, but he's still repeating this idea of Jesus is showing selfless love, agape love, sacrificial love. But I want you to notice what he says before verse 34 and 35 and what he says after that, because if you do, I think we have a good definition of this word love, as far as this is how Jesus walked and this is how we need to be if we're going to say let's walk like Jesus the way that he did. Verse 33 of John 13. He says, "Little children, I am with you a little while longer. You will seek me, and I will say to you, just like I said to the Jews, where I'm going, you cannot come." That sounds a little bit harsh, doesn't it? Where I'm going, you cannot come quite yet. So we could say that love is eventually going to the place where we need to go. We're going to go to the place where we need to go. He says that in verse 33, but then if you read just a little bit ahead, verse 36, talking to Simon Peter, he asks, "Lord, where are you going?" And Jesus said, "Where I go, you cannot follow me now, but you will follow later." You just can't come right now, but you'll be able to come later. Well, where is Jesus going? Well, in John chapter 7, he's going to say that exact same thing at the Feast of Booths, in that big context, in a large crowd, and he tells the Jews, just like what he said in verse 33, he says, "Where I'm going, you cannot come," and then he gives us a hint where he's going to be with the Father. That's exactly what he has right here in John chapter 13. Love is eventually going to the place where we need to go. Jesus says, you are going to be able to come, but you cannot come with me. You're going to be with me one day with the Father. And you know what's really cool about that thought is that he makes no to that right into John chapter 14. Look at John 14, starting in verse 1. He says, "Do not let your heart be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me." And here's where it is. Verse 2, "In my Father's house are many dwelling places. If it were not so, I would have told you, for I go to prepare a place for you. If I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also." What's really cool about this is in verse 2, where it says that the Father has many dwelling places, that word right there in John 14, verse 2, if you read on ahead in John chapter 14 and verse 23, we see this word dwelling places, but it's written in our English language, written differently, and it would be the word abode. It could be different even from that, just depending on the translation you use. So you go to verse 23 of John 14, notice what it says. 14 verse 23, Jesus answered and said to him, "If anyone loves me, he will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him and make our abode with him." We will bring our dwelling place to that individual, the one who is going to love us, the one who's going to sacrificially, selflessly love us, wanting to put our needs before his or her own needs. And isn't that interesting how he says that in verse 23, anyone who loves, that person is also going to keep my word. That's exactly what he has been saying, isn't it? Going back to John 13, 34, and 35, he says, this is the commandment I give to you, that you love one another, even as I have loved you. This is exactly what he says in verse 35. Everyone's going to know that you belong to me, that you follow me, if you love one another. He says it in John chapter 15, 12, and 13, that look, this is what friends do. We selflessly love one another, and that's the same exact concept that you need to do, that you need to follow if you want to make it to the place where you need to go, because that's what love is. Love is eventually going to the place where you need to go. That's how you get there, because when I love Jesus, when I love God, that means I love his word. I'm willing to do whatever it says I need to do in my life, no matter what, no ifs, ands, or buts, no hesitations, and that's exactly what I do. That's exactly the point that Jesus said. This is what helps you get to where I am going. But it's really cool how it says also in John 13, verse 33, where he says, little children, I am with you a little while longer. That's interesting because of what had just been taken place, or what just took place in John 13. Jesus saying, I'm not going to leave so soon. I'm going to stay with you just a little bit longer. A little bit longer. And that should baffle us, because even though it's way after with what Jesus said there in verse 38 of John 13, he tells Peter, look, you're going to deny me. But yet Jesus says, I'm going to stay with you for a little bit longer. Maybe to us, we ask Jesus, why would you want to stay a little bit longer when you are going to eventually say, knowing that Jesus knows all things, that one of your people, Peter, is going to deny you. You would think you would want to get out of there, but he says, no, I'm going to stay with you a little while longer. You go to the very beginning of John chapter 13, John chapter 13, and we read verses 1, 2, and 3, that Judas, another person of his group, is going to betray him, and yet he says, even letting us know that, I'm going to stay with you a little longer. Why? Why would you want to do that when you know someone's going to betray you? And we find out that answer in verse 1 of John chapter 13. It says, now before the feast of the Passover, Jesus, knowing that his hour had come, that he would depart out of this world to the Father, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the very end. That's exactly why Jesus says, I'm going to stay a little bit longer, even though I know one of y'all is going to betray me, even though I know one of y'all is going to deny me. I'm not going to leave so soon. That's what love is, isn't it? Love is this idea of, I'm not going to leave so soon. I'm going to stay with you just a little bit longer and show you this is what love is. And love is also going to the place we are eventually supposed to be going, because that concept of love is going to help us get to that place where we eventually need to go, where we eventually need to be. That this is how Jesus walked concerning this subject of his love. He walked in such a way when it came to his love, showing us, here's a place, you get to go there, here's how you get to go there, putting Jesus' needs before our own needs. When we do, guess we get to go. Jesus and the Father bring their abode, their dwelling place down to us. That's the person who gets to go to heaven. And Jesus has even promised that concept of, he is still with us, even though we have not made it there quite yet. He says, I'm always going to be with you to the very end of the age. Man, Jesus, why would you do that? Because sometimes we get into the trap of betraying him. Sometimes we may get into the trap of denying him. Maybe not by literally saying those things as far as an act of betrayal, an act of denial, but maybe by our actions. Jesus says, I'm still not going to leave you. And Jesus says, it's because I still love you. That doesn't mean that we're free to do whatever we want. He's given us this time to repent, and that's why we can say Jesus' love is so powerful, because of that thought. I pray this is encouraging to you. Pray this is uplifting to you. Consider liking and sharing this video, as well as liking and sharing this page. I've been your host, Remy, or better known as Remington Afri, the youth minister at the Meadows Church of Christ, right here in Beaumont in the great state of Texas. You can find us 9195 Dishman Road, 9195 Dishman Road. Please come worship with us. Visit us Sunday mornings at 9:30 a.m., Bible class at 11 a.m. for all ages, Sunday evenings at 5 p.m., and Wednesday nights at 6:30 p.m. Again, I've been your host, Remy, or better known as Remington Afri, the youth minister at the Meadows Church of Christ right here in Beaumont in the great state of Texas. Not really raving about a word or a phrase, but we're raving about a message that was given to our young people at camp. Had camp a couple weeks ago. We looked at the theme, walking in the footsteps of Christ. How did he walk in his childhood, his teaching, his work, his friendship, and now we just looked at it, his love. And again, pray this is uplifting and encouraging to you. Please consider liking and sharing this video, as well as liking and sharing our page. Continue to have a great rest of your Thursday and a great rest of your week, and Lord willing, we'll see you next time tomorrow around 3 p.m. on another edition of Remy's Rave of the Day. Godspeed.